हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल नेम्ड कंप्यूटर द वे ऑफ लाइफ। आई एम डॉक्टर अजय कुमार मिश्रा, विशिंग यू ऑल ए गुड हेल्थ विथ योर फैमिली मेम्बर्स एंड फ्रेंड्स। फ्रेंड्स, टू डील विद द चैलेंजेज ऑफ डायनेमिक डाटा सेट एंड द लार्ज साइज, कंप्यूटर बिकम्स ए इंडिस्पेंसिबल पार्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ। वाइल डिजाइनिंग अ कंप्यूटर, मोर इम्पोर्टेंस इज गिवन ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ द ह्यूमन बींग, task that a computer can perform, its performance and efficiency, its shape, size and look. But at the same time, human anatomy, the way of interaction with the human and other elements of the system are ignored. As a result, many physical and mental problems are arising and sometimes can lead to long-term disability. Ergonomics is the science of designing user interaction with equipment and workplaces to fit the user. The proper ergonomic design is necessary to prevent repetitive state injuries, which can develop over time and can lead to permanent disability. This video is an effort to provide an insight to understand the basic concept of ergonomics and its importance on computer professionals. Friends, to perform daily activities in real-world environment and to ease the task, we are using number of technological tools. While using these tools, the user's capabilities and limitations, quality of equipment, information and the environment must suit each other. To assess the suitability between a person and the used technology, ergonomics plays a vital role, and the performance of this is assessed by ergonomists. Ergonomists are the persons who consider the activity being done and the demand on the user. The equipment used, that is, its size, shape, and how appropriate it is for the task, and the information used, that is, how it is presented, assessed, and changed. Ergonomics is defined by International Ergonomic Association, that is, IEA, as a scientific discipline concerned with the understanding of interactions among human beings and other elements of a system, and the profession that applies theory, principles, data and methods to design in order to optimize human well-being and overall system performance. It includes many disciplines like anthropometry, biomechanics, mechanical engineering, industrial design, kinesiology, that is the study of mechanics of body movements to provide information about the state of health of all body organs and system. Then physiology and psychology. As a whole, we can say ergonomics is a scientific discipline concerned with the man-machine interaction to get the best by providing ease of task environment which is human-friendly and ensure sustainability. It is employed to fulfill the two goals, that is health and productivity. Next, domains of ergonomics. As per the International Ergonomics Association, ergonomics is broadly divided into three domains. Number one, physical ergonomics. Number two, cognitive ergonomics. And number three, organizational ergonomics. Physical ergonomics is concerned with physical activities. It is concerned with human anatomy and some of the anthropometry, physiological and biomechanical characteristics. In case of cognitive ergonomics, it is concerned with mental processes like perception, memory, reasoning and motor response. They affect interaction among humans and other elements of a system that includes mental workload, decision making, skilled performance, human-computer interaction, human reliability, work stress and training. And in case of organizational ergonomics, it is concerned with the optimization of socio-technical systems that includes organizational structures, policies and processes. It includes the areas like communication, work design and their time slot, teamwork, participatory design, cooperative work, new work programs, crew response management and quality management. Now we will discuss about aspects of ergonomics. Ergonomics has five basic aspects, and if these aspects are taken into consideration, then the quality of product and performance of system will improve. The five basic aspects are safety, comfort, ease of use, productivity or performance, and aesthetic. First, safety. Ergonomics can discover the optimum font size, color and size to enhance readability using limited space available on a medicine label. Basing on this, font sizes could be enlarged so the persons with impaired vision can more easily read the label instructions. Then comfort. Ergonomic principles based on contrast principles could be used to design automatic dimming functions in low light environments. When user turn off the room light to sleep or to avoid a harshly bright light or keeping one awake when surrounding are dark, then ease of use. In an unfamiliar area, it is quite a difficult task to spot stress signs. This could be addressed by using principles of visual detection to make stress signs more visible. Then productivity. The use of ergonomically designed office furniture and equipments like office chairs and computer input devices can drastically reduce work-related injuries and employee absence. Then aesthetic. Signs in the workplace could be made more aesthetic by using a consistent format throughout the workplace. Now it's a time to discuss ergonomic tips for computer users. As we know, the prolonged use of computer can be the cause of muscle ache, nerve pain, and may lead to permanent injury that may be physical or mental. We can work more comfortably and safely if we incorporate the following ergonomic tips into our work styles. Number 1, posture and positioning. Number 2, work technique. Number 3, work environment. And number 4, lifestyle. In the subsequent style, we will discuss one after another in details. First, we will discuss about posture and positioning. While working with computer, the proper posture and its proper positioning must be maintained in the working place. For this, following points should be taken care of. First, maintain good posture and utilize a chair with back support while working. Then, use feet support on the floor or on a footrest while working to reduce pressure on our lower back. Then, frequently used items should be positioned directly in front of our eyes and angled upward on a copy holder to avoid bending and twisting our neck or trunk. Then, keep our shoulder relaxed with our elbows close to our sides. Then, avoid resting our elbows and palms on the hard surface or edge of table. For this, proper pads can be used. Then, elbows should be positioned and 100 to 110 degree when working in order to keep a relaxed position at the keyboard. Then, our wrist should be in the neutral or straight position when keying or using a pointing device or calculator. Wrist rest can assist us in maintaining a neutral position when used properly during pause. Then, float our arms above the keyboard and wrist rest when keying. Then, avoid planting our wrist on the table or wrist rest. This can result in bending the wrist either up or down or side to side. Then, take breaks. Take breaks can be brief and should include stretches for optimal results. If possible, take a 1 or 2 minute break every 15 to 20 minutes or a 5 minute break every hour. And then, every few hours, get up, move around and do an alternative activity. Next tip is work technique. It is also equally important to maintain the proper working technique in the working environment. For this, we have to follow the following points. First, reduce keystrokes with the use of macros or software programs allowing strict keys. Then, use scroll locks and keystroke combinations to reduce pointing device movements. Then, alternate tasks to make changes in our working position to avoid making the same movement for a prolonged period of time. Then, keep our fingers and knuckles relaxed when working at the keyboard. Then, never hold a pen or pencil in our hand when keying. Then, avoid hitting the keyboard with excessive force. Studies have shown that the average user hits the keyboard with 4 times the required force when keying. Next, avoid holding our pointing device tightly. Our hands should be relaxed. And then rest our eyes by refocusing on distant objects intermittently when working. Next tip is work environment. In addition to work technique, we also have to focus on the working environment. For this, following points should be considered. First, avoid excessive reaching. Keep keyboard, pointing device, files, and telephone within easy reach. Then, use a keyboard tray to properly position our keyboard and pointing devices. Then, use copy holder and position in line with our monitor and keyboard. Then, position the monitor in such a way that the viewed part of the screen allows us to keep our neck in a neutral or straight position. For this, the monitor should be positioned directly in front of us. The top of the computer screen should be slightly below the top of our head so that we are looking at it with a slightly downward gaze. Then customize our computer by using our software. The contrast, screen front, pointer size, speed, and color can also be adjusted to maximize our comfort and efficiency. Fourth tip is lifestyle, which has its own significance. If this tip is followed properly, then we can optimize the physical and mental injuries. For this, we have to follow the points mentioned, such as routine use of non-prescribed medications or a wrist brace is not recommended. Then, if we notice any uncommon symptoms, bring into the notice of our supervisor or expert. Slight changes made at early stage can avoid future complications. Then, perform aerobic exercise to gain sustainable strength that improve cardiovascular conditioning and counteract the strain of secondary computer use. Now, this slide shows an ideal working posture and overall setup while working with computer. In the adjacent picture, we can observe the person is sitting at shoulder relaxed with back straight and low back support. For this, he may use cushion. Forearms are level or tilted down slightly with the keyboard, while sitting thighs are slightly tilted and the front of seat not pressing on back of knees, and feet are placed flat on the floor or resting on a footrest. There must be clearance under work surface to move the legs as and when required. The monitor or screen on the top of the table should be placed slightly below eye level, and the distance between the person operating the system and the screen must be from 18 to 28 inches or approximately arm's length of the user. And most importantly, to position the screen to avoid reflected glare. In addition to this, if the points mentioned earlier were maintained properly, then there is a fair chance to optimize the physical and mental injuries. After having a detailed discussion, we can conclude: to meet the upcoming demands and challenges, the dependency on various types of machines are increasing, where computer has its own significance. While designing a computer, more focus is given on speed, memory consumed, performance, efficiency, and the task they perform. But unfortunately, human anatomy and the way of interaction with the human and other elements of a system are ignored. As a result, many physical and mental problems are arising and sometimes may lead to long-term disability. Ergonomics, being an interdisciplinary subject, playing a vital role to assess the suitability between a person and the used technology, and the performance of this is assessed by ergonomists. Ergonomics helps to understand the interactions among human and other elements of a system. This applies theory, principles, data, and methods to design in order to optimize human well-being and overall system performance. It is the study of man-machine interaction to get the best by providing ease of task environment which is human-friendly and ensure sustainability. The proper ergonomic design prevents from repetitive stable injuries that can develop over time and can lead to permanent disability it is employed to fulfill the two goals, that is health and productivity. With this, I remain. Hope you all have enjoyed it. Thank you for your patient hearing. Also suggest the topic of interest you want to explain me in future.